हाई चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम अगेन टू ऑनलाइन लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ श्री बसव पब्लिक स्कूल. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव बीन रीडिंग द स्टोरी टॉम व्हाइट वॉशर्स ऑफेंस. लेट अस कंक्लूड दिस स्टोरी इन टूडेज सेशन. इन टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रीडिंग लास्ट थ्री पैराग्राफ्स, एक्सप्लेनेशन, न्यू वर्ड्स, थीम ऑफ द लेसन एंड ब्रीफ नोट अबाउट ऑथर. सो विदाउट For the delay, shall we start reading today's paragraphs? Here we have the last three paragraphs. I will read them and listen carefully. By the time Ben was tired, Tom had traded the next chance to Billy Fisher for a kite, and then Johnny Miller was bought in for a dead rat and a string to swing it with, and so on, hour after hour. By the middle of the afternoon, Tom was literally rolling in wealth. He had, besides the things before mentioned, 12 marbles, part of a jew's harp, a piece of blue bottle glass to look through, a spool cannon, a key that wouldn't unlock anything, a fragment of chalk, a glass stopper of a decanter, a tin soldier, a couple of tadpoles, 6 firecrackers, a kitten with only one eye, a brass door knob, a dog collar, the handle of a knife, 4 pieces of orange peel, and a dilapidated old window sash. So next paragraph. He had a nice, good, idle time all the while. Plenty of company. And the fence had 3 coats of whitewash on it. If he hadn't run out of whitewash, he would have bankrupted every boy in the village. Tom had discovered a great law of human action without knowing it, namely that in order to make a man or a boy covet a thing, it is only necessary to make the thing difficult to attain. That work consists of whatever a body is obliged to do, and that play consists of whatever a body is not obliged to do. So this is the today's paragraphs and also the climax of the story, how Tom Sawyer successfully completed the task. Here you can see the list of meaning of new words. You can take the screenshot and write it down and also underline these. So dear students, in the previous class we came to know that how the Ben Rogers was made to whitewash the fence, is it? So today's let us see how the other children took the chance of whitewashing the fence. Look at the picture. Here Ben Rogers was whitewashing the fence after giving the apple. At that time, Tom was sitting under a tree and munching the apple. You can see the picture. So, hour after hour, means every moment, Tom was getting other boys for whitewashing the fence. By the middle of the afternoon, exactly when Ben Roger was tired, you can see the picture. When Ben was tired, Tom gave the chance to Billy Fisher. You can see the picture. He was another Tom's friend. Billy Fisher gave the kite to get the chance to whitewash. So he given the kite. Then in the same manner, Johnny Miller got a chance after giving a dead rat and a string to swing the rat. String means thread. So many children got the chance in the same manner. So exactly afternoon, in the middle of afternoon, he was having more health. Besides, it means in addition to, already Tom had taken dead rat and a kite. So beside, list of things below mentioned, which those are? Here you can see the list. Marbles, a part of a jew's harp, it means a part of a musical instrument, a piece of blue bottle glass to look through, a school cannon, it means bundle, that bundle, you can see the picture. A key that wouldn't unlock anything. And a fragment of chalk, a piece of a chalk. A glass stopper of a decanter, it means a handle stopper container. These are a thing. A tin soldier. A couple of tadpoles, it means baby frogs. Six firecrackers. We can count it. And a kitten with only one eye. Kitten means small cat, baby cat. A brass door knob. It is a thing. A dog collar. The handle of a knife, old knife, broken knife, and four pieces of orange peel, and last, a dilapidated old window sash, it means disrepaired window sash, rectangle frame of sash. So these are the things Tom got these things to give the chance of whitewashing the fence to other boys. So he had very enjoyable time. He had nice, good. Tom had nice, good, idle time all the while. It means idle means lazy time, very enjoyable time with plenty of company. It means so many boys company. So after completion of whitewashing, already the fence has done three times and it's looking very nice. It was just magnificent. If the whitewash was not over, Tom would have bankrupted every boy in the village of his proudest professions. Bankrupted means robbed. So by using this trick, he came to know that a great law of human action. Tom was not aware of that law. What was that? Here you can see the, in order to make a man or a boy covet a thing, it is only necessary to make the thing difficult to attain. It means if you wanted to make others to do the work, what we need to do? We have to create the interest. If the interest is created, that work will be done very easily. So without knowing, he find a new law of human beings, human action. So in the last lines, that work consists of whatever a body is obliged to do, and that play consists of whatever a body is not obliged to do. Here, there is a comparison between work and play. Work is a systematic action and play is funny movement or it is enjoyable. So what we think? We think that work is burden, play is enjoyable. So that attitude we have. Okay. So, but if we think that work is game, then we don't feel that it is tired, restless, boring. So we have to change our attitude towards the work. If we think work is burden, we can't carry out. It is difficult to achieve. So this is the law which is discovered by the boy Tom Sawyer. So here it is a one thought has arisen, is it? So this is the overall story of Tom Whitewasher's offense. Finally, we have completed this story. I hope you understood this story. And read this entire lesson, you will get the theme of the lesson. And you will be ready for answering any question. So we came to know that the theme. This small part is taken from the main story, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. The story Whitewashing the Fence is about the protagonist Tom. Protagonist means leader. Leader Tom, how he implies his teamwork skills and makes the difficult task given by Aunt Polly easy. So now here you can see the brief information about author. Who is author? Mark Twain. But Mark Twain is a pen name. He is pen name Mark Twain, but his actual name Samuel Longhorn Clemens. Samuel Longhorn Clemens. He was born on 30th November 1835 in Florida, Missouri. Clemens wrote under the pen name Mark Twain and went on to pen several novels, including two major classics of American literature, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer and The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. He was also a riverboat pilot, journalist, lecturer, entrepreneur, and inventor. Twain died on 21st April 1910 in Redding, Connecticut. This is a brief information about author. So now this is your homework. Today's homework. Write the meaning of new words and theme of the lesson and brief note of author in English notebook. Read the entire lesson and all the meaning of new words. Is it clear? Dear students, we have completed our first lesson. I hope you understood this. If you have any doubts, you can call or text me. So we will back with the exercise part. Okay, we will discuss about exercise part in the next session. Till then, goodbye. Good luck, my dear students. Thank you for watching the video.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.